If you've heard Roland say auto calibration and you're curious, why is this important or how do I do it? Today we're going to talk about that, so let's get started. So this applies to all of the new Rolands, so the LG MG, the VG3 SG3, and the AP640. We have a VG3 right here, so we're just going to get into it. So you can see we already loaded the media in and pushed the lever down, so we're going to go over to the screen and press setup. We're going to go ahead and press new. From there, you can type in whatever you're looking for. This is alpha 6mm, so we'll go ahead and type that in here. And then hit okay, next. If you're gonna use the take-up reel, you can set that up now. We're not, so we're gonna go ahead and say, do not use take-up reel. It's gonna detect the media width here, so it's gonna go all the way to the left. The scanner will come on, and then it's gonna go all the way to the right. You'll get your media width from there. If you set up your media clamps improperly, it's gonna tell you that now. Ours hopefully are set up properly, so we shouldn't get the warning. If we do, you're just gonna wanna adjust the media clamps like it says here. So I'll just press okay. You just wanna check that they're in the right spot. So you can see this one's a little too far to the right, so we're just gonna move it back. You're looking for half moons in these two circles there. So I'll just slide this over. You wanna do this on the one on the right and the one on the left. Just check that they're both right. That one was too far over, so we'll go ahead and slide it back into place. That should be all set. We'll close the front cover. Come back over here. If you're gonna only cut, you can pick that option now. Most people are gonna use the print and print and cut option. I wouldn't worry about this screen at all. This is gonna be controlled from VersaWorks when you bring in the print profiles. We're only worried about media gap and feed calibration, which is gonna be on this next screen. From here, you have the print head height. You can go in ahead and adjust that from in here. If you look all the way into the back here, you can see low, middle, high. I always start on low. We're already on low, so I'm just gonna go ahead and hit next. If the print head is too low, it'll tell you at some point in the screen, and then it'll tell you to adjust it up. You can adjust it to middle or adjust it to high. You can go ahead and execute a print test here, like a nozzle print test, so if you have anything wrong with your machine. If you just set it up, run the print test. If you've run it already or if it's not a new machine, I wouldn't worry about it at this point. I would just go to the next one. The other option on this screen is the change start location. So for some reason you wanted to start, you know, right in the middle at 24 inches or at 30 inches or something, you can go ahead and click that option. We're just gonna start all the way on this right here, so we'll just hit next. From here, this is where you're gonna do the auto calibration. So this is gonna do auto feed and auto media gap calibration. So it's gonna do that before. We used to do that on the VG2. You would do it manually. So basically you would print them, you'd pull it out, you'd look at it, see which one option looked best. You tell it this one, it would print it again. You do that a few times over and over again until you got the right feed. This is gonna do both of those options automatically for you. It is gonna take a little bit of time, so be aware of that. But all you're gonna have to do is hit next. You're gonna go ahead and execute, and it's gonna go ahead and run that test right now. So you can see the printer come out, and then it's gonna go ahead and run that test. You can see it show up on the screen once it's ready to run. We'll let that run, and then we'll come back and show you it at the end. Is the Jeopardy theme copyrighted? Ta-da. So you can see we loaded some reflective onto this printer now. If we go through the same process of going setup, new, we type in reflective on here and then hit okay. What's gonna happen is it's gonna go to scan that width like it did before. You can see the printer going across, the light will come on, it'll scan. The problem is the reflective is gonna mess with the sensor. So what's gonna happen is when that comes back across, we're gonna get an error that says couldn't detect media width. From there, you're gonna go ahead and say, okay, let's manually set it up. It's gonna bring that back out. And the light is gonna be how you set your width from left to right. We can go ahead and hit change if we want to. You can tell it what width it is if you want to, but the better way to do it is to just say, yep, this should be fine. You can see we're moving it left and right here. So go ahead and set where your right edge is. So you wanna basically move this cutter to where the pinch roller is. So you can see if you look right in there where the pinch roller is. I'm gonna hit okay just once I get inside there. It's gonna move down to the right side and I'm gonna do the same thing. I'm gonna move it just inside the pinch roller. And then once you get it inside the pinch roller here, a little too far probably. If you hold it down too far, it goes fast, so you gotta tap, tap, tap. And again, if you didn't need to use all the width, right? If you already knew you were gonna print 24 inches, like just get it close and hit okay. But we're just inside this pinch roller here. We're gonna go ahead and hit okay. And it's gonna bring it all the way back. And then we're at the same point where before we hit okay. And then we're on this print only. And you do the same exact steps that we did in the previous one just to finish out this calibration. It's gonna do the print all the same. We just wanted to show you what that error will look like. We hope this showed you how to do this, why it's important, and what to do if you run into any errors. If you found this video helpful, let us know in the comments below. If you're interested in anything else on this printer, or really any of the printers that we sell, leave a comment. We're happy to cover it in another video. But thanks for watching. We'll see you in the next video.